Good morning students. Yesterday we have completed the second chapter 2D. So hope you understood there and you have come across with the comprehension. That is comprehension 1 page number 12. So why was Monaco called a tall kingdom? Because it had a very less inhabitants. It had only 7,000 inhabitants. That's the point here. So it is very necessary to go with the comprehension as per the as you listen or as you read the textbook. It makes you sense to read go with the comprehension and attempt for the questions over there. So it is just comprehension you need to keep in mind. So even in Romeo Juliet, I hope you have clarified over there after going with the comprehension. So Romeo Juliet comprehension, which one? Let me come. See, I'll come with the comprehension one. The phrase, teach the torches to burn bright. It talks about the Juliet's, her beauty surpasses the brightness of the light. That is, the answer is C. So next I'll come with the second one. That is, for earth too dear. Means, it suggests that it's very rare. Of course, all these three are here, are the right one. But which is very near answer is the main thing, students. So, I told you dear means rare, expensive and etc. As per the Shakespearean comprehension over here, it is divine. So for earth to dear means divine. Next up, third one, the measure done connotes the completion of, it is, it may be possible of A and B, both are right. So and the fourth is, that is C, Romeo feels this is true love. And the fifth is, that is B, description of Romeo's charm. A new snow phrase shows the description of Romeo's charm. So now, what similes does Romeo use to convey Juliet's beauty? So in the textbook, you can see that he goes on comparing with her. For example here, as a rich jewel. Similes means comparison. As a means agiye, atarane ide. Like this. This is rich jewel in an Ethiopia. Too rich for use for earth, so shows his snowy dove. So these are all the similes. So what the question talks about? What similes does Romeo use to convey Juliet's beauty? So you have to go on explaining using those similes. Next, how according to Juliet would Romeo be immortalized to the world? That you have to go with the Romeo's, that is sorry, Juliet's soliloquy. And at the end she talks about that. He must be cut into little stars and thrown to the face of heaven. Like this, you have to go with the 80 to 100 words. You have to describe all soliloquy of Juliet. Next, comprehension third, comment on the contrasting imaginary. That is images, I told you. How it is contrasted images. Images are all black and white. You have to go with the reading, contrasting those, extracting images from the text and you have to include in the answer. Now, second one, between Romeo and Juliet, whose love do you think is more passionate and intense? So, I already analyzed this, students. You can go with the thing. Next, let me come with the 2D comprehension. It is page number 12. See now. Why was Monaco called a tall kingdom? Because it has only 7,000 inhabitants. See, whenever the why word comes, you have to go with the sentence, you have to write in a complete sentence because. If it is just like this second one, you see, name the commodities taxed in Monaco, you just mention the word or a phrase, students. Always don't waste time and simply for one mark questions. Because you have to, I think itself they have given a word, a phrase or a sentence. Sentence should be written when the question starts with a why and how. Remaining you have to go with the words. So name the commodity taxed in Monaco: tobacco, wine and spirit and poll tax. Commodities means vastugalu. Yaa vastugala mele avaru tax haaktare. Yaad haaktare? Tobacco haaktare, tambaku ke, wine and spirits. What was the source of king's special revenue? So that is gaming house. Who were its beneficiaries? Yes, his ministers and officials. Next, beneficiaries means those who get help from king. So the those are, that is, those are ministers and officers. Why did the Germans stop gaming house? Because in their country. And how did it benefit Monaco? Germans, because they prohibited, because people used to drown or they suicide themselves after losing the game. And how did it benefit Monaco? Because many people surrounding of Monaco come over there and they play. By this, the owner will get huge profit. So, what was the punishment given to the murderer? It is death sentence. The death sentence was converted into life imprisonment because carrying out death sentence was expensive. Monaco wanted to show mercy on the law. No, it's option B. Next, seventh, how much did the king spend annually on the criminal? How much? 600 francs. You have to write the word correctly, students. Unit, that is currency. F-R-A-N-C-S, francs. On what condition did the criminal agree to go away? That he has to be paid his pension, one-third of his annuity as a pension. How did his demand fulfilled? He was fulfilled by paying the one-third of his pension. Though gambling is a dirty business, why does the king of Monaco restored it to it? So yeah, you have to give a little this is a comprehension too, that is 80 to 100 words. So you have to go with a you have to give one or two, go directly with the, though gambling is a dirty business, you have to introduce about the king's administrative system little bit. And knowing also dirty business, we need to say that. So you have to say he taxed down tobacco and all, he wanted to pay the salary, he had a levies, he had a coronation, all these things. But so he used to get a huge amount from this gambling, that is gaming house. So king did not, does the king Monaco, why does the king of Monaco restored it, means why he maintained it? Because he wanted to pay the salary to his ministers. Why did the king of Monaco keep changing his mind in dealing with the criminal? You can understand why he changed his mind, because after the death sentence, they understood that for a machine and a executioner, it takes nearly 16,000 francs, and it should not be. And the king thought that it should be collected by the people itself, and people have to pay 2 francs per head. All these points you have to keep in mind, and you have to think of the king. And so this is the way he changed his punishments. So you can understand here trial and punishment method. Why was the criminal reluctant? You have to pronounce it as reluctant, students. Reluctant means unwilling. Unwilling means he was not in a way to go out of the prison. Avanu tiraskaristane. Reluctant means avanige ishta illa. Yaake annadu nimge gottide. That whole passage, whole paragraph, that is page number I told you in the while teaching. That is page number 10 now. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 paragraph you have to write. This is I repeat, page number 10, 4th paragraph, you get the answer for this question. You have to go with the indirect speech. Don't write directly what it is in the textbook. Write in an indirect speech. How did the criminal lead his life after his release? At the end, you have the same thing. Page number 11, 2nd paragraph, you read it and try to answer it. Next. Comprehension third, you can't earn stone palaces by honest labor. So, you can analyze your own answer, students, extracting your points from the short story, and you have to write your own. As per the statement, what is telling, there is no value for honesty. If you go on honesty, you can't lead a comfortable life. This is the point here. And if you have if you go with the illegal things and you can earn more money and you can lead, and this is not done. But as per the story, it justifies the, this statement justifies the king's administrative system. You have to extract, elaborate this. Though the trial and imprisonment of the criminal is depicted in a comic mode in this story, of course, it does gives a serious questions. What are they? So these questions can be used to write answer, that is the criminal refusal to go out of the prison. Adishtuna you use maatkodi ee answer na paribodu. Were there other ways of dealing with the criminal? Discuss in the light of the story. There are many ways, students, I told in the analysis. King would have established many employment over there. He would have given occupation to the people. Instead of encouraging gaming girls, he would have done it. And you can write in your own words. So vocabulary, homonyms, you can manage your, read it and do your own. So let me come with the next term. Very interesting poem on children. See students, written by Khalil Gibran. Pre-reading activity. What do your parents expect of you? Can you guess yourself, students? What do your parents expect from you? And you are in already second pew. They have lot of expectation because you have grown up. You have many aims in your life. And naturally, your parents also have their expectation on you. So just think for 1 minute, and after thinking this, you have to read the poem. What do you expect? What do you expect of your parents? Your parents in the yena bayasthira. Antadu idana eradu contrast maatkodi students. Think that you wanted to become an engineer, but your parents wanted you to be a doctor. See, this is all the expectation. So our time alle enagutte when we won't fulfill our expectation and parents won't fulfill our expectation, what are the things may get a difference annadu idondu padya ide. So have you ever felt your parents are too possessive or demanding? Why? So of course you feel sometimes yes, sometimes no, but the story, that is the poem on children, it's instead of telling poem, I can use the word sermon, sermon. So written by Khalil Gibran. See students, before reading this story on children, I want to read the poem once. Before explaining the poem, let me read the poem once. It's very simple, in very simple language. Try to understand, students. And a woman who held a babe against her bosom said, speak to us of children. I repeat. And a woman who held a babe against her bosom said, speak to us of children. And he said, understand? And he said, you'll come to know who is he and who is woman after I narrate the story. And he said, what he said? Your children are not your children. I repeat, your children are not your children. They are the sons and daughters of life's longing for itself. They are the sons and daughters of life's longing for itself. They come through you, but not from you. They come through you, but not from you. And though they are with you, yet they belong not to you. You may give them your love, but not your thoughts. For they have their own thoughts. You may house their bodies, but not their souls. For their souls dwell in the house of tomorrow, which you cannot visit, not even in your dreams. You may strive to be like them, but seek not to make them like you. For life goes not backward, nor tarries with yesterday. You are the bows, very important, underline, bows. You are the bows from which your children are children as living arrows, underline living arrows, are sent forth. The archer sees the mark upon the path of the infinite, and he bends you with his might, that is, arrows, may go swift and far. Let your bending in the archer's hand be for gladness. For even as he loves the arrow that flies, so he loves also the bow that is stable. So this is Khalil Gibran. So Khalil Gibran, 1883 to 1931, is a Lebanese American artist and poet. His poems are considered poetic essays. See, you observed, I think, the lines. They just have a kind of a conversation. So when you read Romeo and Juliet, you find very difficult, different way of writing the sentences. But when you read here this poem, as though the poet is talking to us, anta feel agutte. So idike enanta karithivi, poetic essays. As they do not stick to the unusual versification. That's what I said. There is versification is usually the poem will have rhyme schemes, similes like this, personification. Of course, here also personification and metaphors. Usually, he won't stick in his poems. Khalil Gibran, and he is famous as a Gibran philosophy only. I'll come to later his philosophy, about his philosophy. Versification. The prophet. So, what you reading this on children? It is from the prophet. He is his best known work and has been translated into more than 25 languages, including Kannada. On Children is a selection from the prophet, which offers a critique as of the usual expectation of parents regarding their pair children and urges them to introspect. So this is how we can understand Gibran. Introspect means a kind of a self-consciousness. Parents have their own way of expectation, self-examination. Parents should have a kind of introspection, means they have to examine themselves whether they are right or wrong after reading Khalil Gibran's poems. So here the same thing, All Children is also a type of a introspection to the parents. They have to self-examine them whether they are right or wrong. So now, students, before going to this poem, let me talk here. The speaker, that is Khalil Gibran, in the Prophet, speaks in the persona of Al-Mustafa. Persona means the character of Al-Mustafa. Al-Mustafa is the last paigambar in Islam. You can read in, Prophet is the last paigambar. Okay. So now with the poem, what all you read now on children, it is talked by Al-Mustafa. And our Khalil Gibran acts as a persona of Al-Mustafa. Andre, Al-Mustafa avaru heliradanna, Khalil Gibran tamde adanta padagalinda athwa words inda avaru ee padyana barthidare. Andre, theme Al-Mustafa avarde, adanna avara way of talking alli bartha hogtare Khalil Gibran. Understood? I repeat, the speaker in the prophet speaks in the persona of Al-Mustafa. Okay, persona of Al-Mustafa, A-L-M-U-S-T-A-F-A, Al-Mustafa, the last paigambar of Islam. The keynote of the prophet is parenthesis, that is, Al-Mustafa means the chosen one, that means he is a god, he is named as a god. The name also implies that he possesses spiritual knowledge and divine characteristics. Al-Mustafa is a man of inner purity and is believed to be the perfect man or the universal man. So here Khalil Gibran was highly influenced by Al-Mustafa's sermons. So in his own language he has written by taking the topic of Al-Mustafa. Now what is the prophet? I talk here they are given, this poem is from the prophet anta heltidare. Agidre the prophet anna padyada ಒಂದು ಬುಕ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಬುಕ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೋಯಮ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅನಾಲಜಿ, ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಟಾಕ್ಸ್ ಸಿನಮ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಟ್. ಐ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ದ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ಸ್ 26 ಸರ್ಮನ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ವೇರಿಡ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ಸ್. ಐ ರಿಪೀಟ್, ದ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ಸ್ 26 ಸರ್ಮನ್ಸ್. ಸರ್ಮನ್ಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ರಿಲಿಜಿಯಸ್ ಸ್ಪೀಚ್, ಎಸ್ ಇ ಆರ್ ಎಂ ಓ ಎಲ್. ರಿಲಿಜಿಯಸ್ ಸ್ಪೀಚ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಧರ್ಮದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಪ್ರಚಾರ ಮಾಡೋದು ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಅಥವಾ ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಪ್ರವಚನ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ, ಅದನ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾ. ಸೊ ಈ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ಒಂದು ಪದ್ಯದ ಪುಸ್ತಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾ ಹೇಳಿರೋ ಅಂತ ಸರ್ಮನ್ಸ್ ಗಳು ಇವೆ. ಇದನ್ನ ಅವರು ಖಲೀಲ್ ಗಿಬ್ರಾನ್ ಅವರ ಒಂದು ಥೀಮ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 26 ಸರ್ಮನ್ಸ್ ಇವೆ ಆನ್ ವೇರಿಡ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಲವ್, ಮ್ಯಾರೇಜ್, ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಹೌಸಸ್, ಕ್ಲೋತ್ಸ್, ಲಾಸ್, ಕ್ರೈಮ್, ಪನಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ಬೈಯಿಂಗ್, ಸೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ. ಈ ತರ 21 ಟಾಪಿಕ್ಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಈ ಸರ್ಮನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾ. ಸೊ ನಾವ್ ದ ಸರ್ಮನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗೀವನ್ ಬೈ ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾ ಹೂ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೋಯೆಟ್. ಐ ರಿಪೀಟ್, ದ ಸರ್ಮನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗೀವನ್ ಬೈ ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾ. ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾ ಹೂ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೋಯೆಟ್. ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ ಚೂಸನ್ ಒನ್. ಐ ರಿಪೀಟ್, ಚೂಸನ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಗಾಡ್, ಈಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ರೀಟೆಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಗಾಡ್. ನೌ ವೈ ದಿಸ್ ಪೋಯಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಫ್, ವೈ ಈಸ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್? ಸಿ, ವೆನ್ ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾ ವಾಸ್ ರಿಟರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ಫೆಲಸ್, ಓ ಆರ್ ಪಿ ಎಚ್ ಎ ಎಲ್ ಇ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ. ಐ ರಿಪೀಟ್, ಓ ಆರ್ ಪಿ ಎಚ್ ಎ ಎಲ್ ಇ ಎಸ್ ಇ. ಆರ್ಫೆಲಸ್ ಅದು ಒಂದು ಊರು, ಅದು ಒಂದು ಪಿಲಿಗ್ರಿಮೇಜ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆರ್ ಹೋಲಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಸೊ ಈ ಗೋಸ್ಟ್ ಈ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಗಾನ್ ಟು ದೇರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಈ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಟು ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಸೊ ಆನ್ ದ ಸೇಲಿಂಗ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಶಿಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ವಾಪಸ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇರ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಜನ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಪಿಲ್ಗ್ರಿಮ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ರು, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ತೀರ್ಥಯಾತ್ರೆ ಹೋಗಿರೋರು. ವಾಪಸ್ ಬಂದಾಗ ಆ ಹಡಗಿನಲ್ಲಿ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಶೇಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾ ಕೂಡ ಒಬ್ರು ಇದ್ರು. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆರ್ಫೆಲಸ್ ಇಂದ ವಾಪಸ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇರ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ he met many pilgrims in the ship. So many pilgrims asked al mustafa to talk about a different topic. So like this, one of the topics is on children, and it was asked by a woman called al mitra, a l m I t r a. ಬರ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಆ ಅಡಿಗಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಒಬ್ಬ ಪಿಲಿಗ್ರಿಮ್ ಇದ್ರು, ಅವಳ ಹೆಸರು ಅಲ್ ಮಿತ್ರ ಅಂತ ಕೂಡ. ಅವಳು ಕೂಡ ಒಬ್ಬ ಸೀರಿಯಸ್, ಎಸ್ ಇ ಇ ಆರ್ ಇ ಡಬಲ್ ಎಸ್. ಸೀರಿಯಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಭವಿಷ್ಯವಾಣಿ ನುಡಿತಾರೆ, ಭವಿಷ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಇವಳು ಅದನ್ನ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತ, ಅವಳು ಭವಿಷ್ಯ ನುಡಿಯೋಳು. ಇವಳು ಅಲ್ ಮಿತ್ರ ಅವ್ರ ಅಲ್ ಮಿತ್ರ ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾಗೆ ಆನ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನ ನಾವು ಹೇಗೆ ಬೆಳೆಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ, ಪೋಷಕರಾಗಿರೋರು ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಬೆಳೆಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಹೇಳಿ, ಅದನ್ನ ನಮ್ಗೆ ತಿಳಿಸ್ಕೊಡಿ ಅಂತ ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾಗೆ ಅಲ್ ಮಿತ್ರ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ಕೇಳ್ದಾಗ ಅವಾಗ ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾ ಈ ಒಂದು ಸರ್ಮನ್ ನ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದೇ ನೋಡಿ ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅ ವುಮನ್, ಅ ವುಮನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಯಾರು ಅಲ್ ಮಿತ್ರ ಆರ್ ಅಲ್ ಮಿತ್ರ ಇನ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಅಲ್ ಮಿತ್ರ ಎ ಎಲ್ ಎಂ ಐ ಟಿ ಆರ್ ಎ ಅಲ್ ಮಿತ್ರ ಹೂ ಹೆಲ್ಡ್ ಎ ಬೇಬ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅವರ್ ಬಾಸಮ್. ಬಾಸಮ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಚೆಸ್ಟ್. ತನ್ನ ಎದೆಗೆ ತನ್ನ ಮಗುನ ಉಚ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತಾಳೆ, ಮಗುನ್ ನೋಡ್ಕೋತಾ ಕೇಳ್ತಾಳೆ ಏನಂತ. ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಟು ಅಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ನಮಗೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ನಾನು ಹೇಗೆ ಬೆಳೆಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು ನನಗೆ ತಿಳಿಸ್ಕೊಡಿ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಾಳೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈ ಸೆಟ್, ಈ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರು ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾ. ಬರ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾ ಎ ಎಲ್ ಎಂ ಯು ಟಿ ಎಫ್ ಯು ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ರೈಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಟ್. ಈ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರು ದ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಟ್ ಪಿ ಎಚ್ ಸಾರಿ ಪಿ ಆರ್ ಓ ಪಿ ಎಚ್ ಇ ಟಿ ದ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಟ್ ಪಿ ಆರ್ ಓ ಪಿ ಎಚ್ ಇ ಟಿ ದ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಈ ಸೆಡ್, ಈ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾರು ದ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಟ್ ಸೆಡ್ ಏನಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಯುವರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್. ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಕೆಟಗಾರಿಕಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಅಂಡರ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬರೀರಿ. ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್, ಯುವರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಲಿ ಅಪ್ಲೈಡ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನರಿ, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಯರ್. ದ ಓಲ್ ಸೆರ್ಮನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನರಿ ಕಾನ್ವರ್ಸೇಷನ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಅವರ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕರ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಖಲೀಲ್ ಗಿಬ್ರನ್. ಏನಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರಂತೆ, ಯಾರು ಅಲ್ಮಿತ್ರ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರಂತೆ, ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ತಿಳಿಸಿದಾಗ ಪ್ರಾಫೆಟ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಂತೆ ಕೆಟಗಾರಿಕಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರಂತೆ. ಏನಿದು ಕೆಟಗಾರಿಕಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಇದು ಪರ್ಸನಲ್ ಆಗಿ ತಗೊಳೋ ಹಾಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಇಡೀ ಪ್ರಪಂಚದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದಂತ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ಗೂ ಇದು ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ನಾವು, ಕೆಟಗಾರಿಕಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಏನಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಯುವರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್. ಸಿ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಮೇಕೆ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಹೋಗದೆ. ಸೊ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ 14 ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ 14 ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಟಾಕ್ಸ್ ಟು ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾ ಟ್ರೈಸ್ ಟು ಎನ್ಲೈಟನ್ ದ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಐ ರಿಪೀಟ್, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈನ್ ಟು 14 ಲೈನ್ಸ್, 14 ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯಾ, ಯು ಮೇ ಹೌಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಬಾಡಿ ನಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಸೋಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೂ ಇದು 14 ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೂ ಅಂಡರ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬರ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಲ್ ಮುಸ್ತಫಾ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ಎನ್ಲೈಟನ್ ದ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಸಿ ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಕಮ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈನ್. ಆಂಡ್ ಎ ವುಮನ್ ಹೂ ಹೆಲ್ಡ್ ಎ ಬೇಬ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅ ಬೋಸಮ್ ಸೆಡ್, ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಟು ಅಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್. ಆಂಡ್ ಈ ಸೆಡ್, ಯಾರು ಹಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಫೆಟ್, ಯುವರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ದನ್ ಹೂಸ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ದ ಸನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಾಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಲಾಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಿಯಾ, ದೇ ಆರ್ ದ ಸನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಾಟರ್ಸ್. ನೋಡಿ, ಅವರು ಯಾರ ಮಕ್ಕಳು, ಲೈಫ್ ಲಾಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಸೊ ಅವರು ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಅವರು ನಿಮ್ಮ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರೆ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ದೆನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ದ ಸನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಾಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಲಾಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಲೈಫ್ ಲಾಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ ಟು, ಅಂಡರ್ಲೈನ್ ಲೈಫ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಲೈಫ್ ಲಾಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ ಟು ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸ್, ಅವರು ಈ ಪ್ರಪಂಚಕ್ಕೆ ಸೀಮಿತರಾಗಿರುವರು. ಸೊ ನೋಡಿ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇವರೆಲ್ಲ ನನ್ನವರು, ನಾನ್ ಜನ್ಮ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ನಾನ್ ಹೇಳ್ದಂಗೆ ಕೇಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದಿದ್ರೆ ಅದು ತಪ್ಪು. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ದೇ ಆರ್ ದ ಸನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಾಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಫ್ಸ್ ಲಾಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಅವರು ಈ ಭೂಮಿ ಮೇಲೆ ಬರಕ್ಕೂ ಒಂದು ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಇದೆ. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ ಟು ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದೇರ್ ಓನ್ ಪರ್ಪೋಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅರ್ತ್. ಬರ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರ, ದೇ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದೇರ್ ಓನ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಬೋರ್ನ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅರ್ತ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೈಕಿಂಗ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹಿ ವಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಟೀಚ್. ದೇ ಹಿ ಸೇಸ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ದ ಸನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಾಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಲಾಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ದೇ ಕಮ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಯು ಬಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಯು. ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್. ದೇ ಕಮ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಯು ಬಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಯು. ಥ್ರೂ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಮೂಲಕ. ಯು ಆರ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅ ವೆಹಿಕಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದೆಮ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅರ್ತ್. ಥ್ರೂ ಯು ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಲೈನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರೈಟ್. ದೇ ಕಮ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಯು ಆಸ್ ಎ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಎ ವೆಹಿಕಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದೆಮ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಬೋರ್ನ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅರ್ತ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದೋ ದೇ ಆರ್ ವಿತ್ ಯು, ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅವರ್ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ದ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ವಿ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಟಿಲ್ ಅವರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ವಿ ಬಿ ವಿತ್ ಅವರ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಔಟ್ ಅವರ್, ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ 60-70 ಅವರ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ 100 ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ವಿಲ್ ವಿ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಬಿ ಟುಗೆದರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ವೇ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಅಪ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಮೀನ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ನೋ. ಅಂಡ್ ದೋ ದೇ ಆರ್ ವಿತ್ ಯು, ದೇ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಡೋಂಟ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ವಿತ್ ಯು ಯಟ್ ದೇ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟು ಯು. ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ವಿತ್ ಯು ಥ್ರೂ ಔಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಲೈಫ್, ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ದೇ ವೋಂಟ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ ಟು ಯು. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವೈ ದೇ ವೋಂಟ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್? ಡೂ ಯು ಅಗ್ರಿ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್? ಡೋಂಟ್ ಯು ಬಿಲೀವ್ ವಿತ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್? ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್, ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ನೇ ಫಿಸಿಕಲಿ ವಿ ಆರ್, ಇಂಟರ್ ಸೈಕಾಲಜಿಕಲಿ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್, ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದೇರ್ ಓನ್ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್. ಯು ಮೇ ಗಿವ್ ದೆಮ್ ಯುವರ್ ಲವ್ ಬಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್. ಅಂಡರ್ಲೈನ್ ಯಾ, ಯು ಮೇ ಗಿವ್ ದೆಮ್ ಯುವರ್ ಲವ್. ಯುವರ್ ಲವ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟಲ್ ಲವ್, love of the parents. Underline mark bakoli. See, all these phrases you have to understand. It may appear easy, but there is a depth meaning. You need to think of it. You may give them your love. You means your parents. You may give them your love, but not your thoughts. See, this is very important. Parents should understand that they should not possess them. They should not impose their thoughts on their children because they have their own thoughts. Why they should not impose parents their thoughts? Because for they means here children. Children have their own thoughts here. Do you agree, students? Of course, it is 75% correct as per our Indian text. But still, it depends on the individual thinking, students, sometimes. Maybe we can't agree with the Gibran philosophy here. What is telling? You may give them your love, but not your thoughts, because children have their own thoughts. So, you may house their bodies. See how nicely it says. You may house their bodies. House their bodies. Underline and write. Future. You may house their bodies, but not their souls. You may think about their future. House their bodies means future. You may think and you may help them to build to develop their future, but not their souls. You have to pronounce it as souls. It's not souls. Souls. Not their souls. Souls andre illi artha their thinking. Illi atmagalu antalla. Illi avara yochanegalu. But not their souls. For why? What happens to their souls? For their souls. See now. How souls dwell in the house of tomorrow. Please students, make it correction here. You may house their bodies. House their bodies means protect them physically. Underline. You may house their bodies means you may protect them physically, but not their souls. Psychologically, you can't even stop their thinking. But because for their souls dwell in the house of tomorrow. Illi underline matkoli. House of tomorrow means future. For their souls dwell in the house of tomorrow, which you cannot visit, not even in your dreams. Because for their souls dwell in the house of tomorrow. So you can understand here, he is telling to the parents that you can protect them physically, not their psychologically. Because for their house, dwell andre nelesodu, our future, our ಕೈಯಲ್ಲಿರುತ್ತೆ ವಿಚ್ ಯು ಕೆನಾಟ್ ವಿಸಿಟ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ವಿಸಿಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇವನ್ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೇಮ್ ವೇ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಸೋಲ್ಸ್ ಮೇ ಡ್ವೆಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಹೌಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟುಮಾರೋ ವಿಚ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಈ ಸಜೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲಿ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದ ಲೈಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲಿ to own the things that the children don't belong to their parents, all of a 100%, because their souls dwell in the house of tomorrow, which you don't visit, not even in your dreams. So he is suggesting your means your parents. He is telling that for the parents, even you can't dream about their future, in your dreams also you can't think that what their future will be. So, it is better to accept the reality of life. We need not to be possessive. We need not to be demanding on the children because they have their own house of tomorrow. So, like this, he is suggesting the parents, he is advising the parents to view the life practically, to have a practical views in the life, especially in the children case, because parents have their own expectation on the children, but it should not be impose our thoughts. Our means here, parents, they should not impose their thoughts on the children, because instead, parents should understand what their children want to be in their future and support them and make them to develop in those things. Then only there will be progress. This is what Gibran wants to talk practically and understand practically about their growth for the children. Next, what he says, you may strive to be like them, but seek not to make them like you. So You may strive. You strive means struggle. Instead of imposing your thoughts, instead of demanding your thoughts, better you struggle to be like them. You change yourself to their thoughts. What is telling? You struggle to be like them, but seek not to make them like you. Don't ever think that what you have experienced in your life, it should also happen to them also in their life. So this is what is telling. But seek not. Seek means look after, search for. Purpali, seek means search. Search not to make them like you. ಓ ನಾನು ನಾನು ಇನ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ನಾನು ಪೊಲೀಸ್, ಅಥವಾ ನಾನು ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್, ನನ್ನ ಮಗನು ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್, ನಾನು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್, ನನ್ನ ಮಗಳು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್, ಮಗನು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್, ಈ ಥರ ಯಾವತ್ತಿಗೂ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಡ. ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಫಾರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಗೋಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ವರ್ಡ್. ಜೀವನ ಅನ್ನೋದು ನಿನ್ನ ಥರನೇ, ಅದು ವಾಪಸ್ ಬರಲ್ಲ, ವಾಪಸ್ ಹೋಗಲ್ಲ. ಏನಾಯಿತು ಅನ್ನೋದು ನಮಗೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಹಿಂದೆ ನಡೆದಿದ್ದು ಮತ್ತೆ ವಾಪಸ್ಸು ಬರಲ್ಲ. ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಜನ್ರೇಷನ್ನವರು, ಅವರಿಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟ ಆದಂಥ ನಾವು ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಅವರಿಗೆ ಬೆಳೆಯೋಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಗಿಬ್ರನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ಫಾರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಗೋಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ವರ್ಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟ್ಯಾರಿಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಯ ಸ್ಟಡಿ. ಟ್ಯಾರಿಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಲಿಂಗರ್ಸ್. ಓ ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಈ ಸ್ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಯರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಗುಡ್ ಆರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಲೈಫ್ goes not backward, not even lingers about yesterday. It never think about yesterday's, because life will be going on. What happens in the next moment we won't be knowing. So this is what he's suggesting, advising the parents not to think about themselves, what they to happen to them, it should not to be happen to the children. That's what he's talking. He's telling that you may strive to be like them, but seek not to make them like you. Seek means search or look for. For life goes not backward. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೆದಿರೋದು ಮತ್ತೆ ಅದು ವಾಪಸ್ ಬರಲ್ಲ. ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಟ್ಯಾರಿಸ್, ನಾಟ್ ಟ್ಯಾರಿಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಎಸ್ಟರ್ಡೇ. ನಡೆದೇ ಹೋಗಿರೋದು ನಡೆದೋಗುತ್ತೆ, ಆದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳಾಗಿರೋರು ಅವರು ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ನವರು, ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಜನ್ರೇಷನ್, ಅವರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಅವ್ರ ತರ ಇರೋ ಹಾಗೆ ನಾವು ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು ಹೊರತು ನಮ್ ತರನೇ ಅವ್ರು ಇರ್ಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಇಲ್ಲ. ಹೇಳ್ತಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ನೋಡಿ ನಾವಿಷ್ಟು ಕಷ್ಟಪಟ್ಟಿದ್ವಿ, ನಾವು ಅಷ್ಟು ಕಷ್ಟಪಟ್ಟಿದ್ವಿ, ನಾವು ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗಿದ್ವಿ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಿದ್ವಿ, ಇಲ್ಲೋ ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ. ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಶುಡ್ ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡನ್, ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಮೀನ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಟು ದ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಗಿಬ್ರನ್ ಸೇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಟು ದ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟು ಇಂಪೋಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೈನ್ ಇಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಎ ರಿಲಿಜಿಯಸ್ ಲುಕ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೋಯೆಟ್. ಹರಿಪಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪೋಯೆಟ್ ತಮ್ಮ ಧಾರ್ಮಿಕವಾಗಿ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೂ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಅನಿಸುತ್ತೆ, ಆದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಇದು ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಒಬ್ಬ ಮೇನ್ ಒಬ್ರು ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅವ್ರು ಯಾರು ಗಾಡ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ನಮ್ಮ ಲೈಫಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡ್ರು, ಏನೇ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡ್ರು, ನಮ್ಮ ಲೈಫ್ ಯಾರ ಕೈಯಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಮೆಟಫರ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ವರ್ಣನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಪೋಯೆಟ್. ಸೊ ಈ ಲೈನಿಂದ ಈ ಕಂಟುನು So from these lines, you are the bows from which your children are leaving arrows are sent forth. The archer sees the mark upon the path of the infinite and he bends you with his might, that is, his arrows may go swift and far. Let your bending in the archer's hand be for gladness, for even as he loves the arrow that flies, so he also loves the bow that is stable. So did you understand anything, students? See, very religious way our Gibran talks here. What he says, you are the bows, you means here underline, you means parents, are the bows andre gottala billu. So andre understand maatkoli, it is a metaphor for bow, is a metaphor for parents. So he is asking the parents to become a bow instead of imposing their thoughts, instead of expecting lot from their children, demanding from their children. He asks himself, the parents should bend themselves in their thinking. Our bend, our thinking ne change maadkobeku, neevu bow aagbeku, for which your children are leaving arrows. Leaving arrows means children. Write down, student, a metaphor for children. Leaving arrows. See how beautifully Gibran used the metaphor here. Bow and leaving arrows. Not bare arrows. living arrows, understand, they are the active children, they are the future children, future generation. Living arrows are sent forth. If bow bends only, the living arrows can go forth. Forth means forward. It can be forward. That means how beautifully it is said. If parents understand the children's wish and they encourage them, and encouraging is nothing but bending their thinking, bending themselves in their thinking, attitude, the children can send forth. The children will get progressed. If the bow itself is straight, it is not bending, then arrow cannot reach its destination, its aim, its goal. It can't reach. See how nicely is talking here Gabriel. You are the bows from which your children are leaving arrows are sent forth. Forth means forth, forward. See now. Next, what you use the metaphor? The archer. See, underline students. The archer means the God. Devru sees the mark upon the path of infinite. See, God knows the path of infinite. We can guess only, my son or child can become an engineer, but God sees the mark, underline mark upon the path of infinite means God has his own goal, God has his own determination, God has given certain path to reach it, and only that path is the infinite, and it is only done by the God. It is not parents, not children, it is all in the hands of the archer. Archer means the God. The God sees the mark upon the path of infinite, and he, underline he means here, God. Nodi, H capital letter idre, always try to understand H capital letter idre, adu God anta artha. He bends you with his might. Nodi, if the parents are not ready to bend, change their attitude, change their thinking, God knows to bend with his might, that his arrows may go swift and far. He don't think that he is punishing the parents. No, no. He is advising the parents. They have to bend. They have to change themselves. That their leaving arrows has to arrows may go swift and far. So this is how he says the archer sees the mark upon the path of infinite means determination. God knows. God has created everybody's fate. This is the meaning, students. God knows, he is the one who creates our destiny, and he bends you with his might, that his arrows may go swift and far. Swift means straight and far, continuous, constant. Undu reach goal, reach agavargo, a devru parents ke using all his might, he makes the parents to bend, to change themselves in their thinking, and allows the leaving arrows to move there towards to their goals. This is the thing. And never ever think that we are the main. Parents sometimes they think what we decide that is the main. No, above all, namellarkinta obru powerful thing is the archer. Adan Gibran heltidare, ನಾವ್ ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಇದ್ರು ಕೂಡ ಲೈಫ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಹಣೆ ಬರ ಆ ದೇವರು ಬರ್ದಿರ್ತಾನೆ ಅಂತ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ತಿಳಿಸ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ದ ಆರ್ಚರ್ ಸೀಸ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದ ಪಾತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇನ್ಫಾನೆಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹೀ ಬೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಯು ವಿತ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಮೈಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾರೋಸ್ ಮೇ ಗೋ ಸ್ವಿಫ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್. ಲೆಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯುವರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯರ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಲೆಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬೆಂಡಿಂಗ್, ಬೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಚೇಂಜಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್. ಇನ್ ದ ಆರ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಬಿ ಫಾರ್ ಗ್ಲಾಡ್ನೆಸ್. ಸಿ ಸೋ ನೈಸ್. ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಎಷ್ಟು ನೀವ್ ಬೆಂಡ್ ಆಗ್ತೀಯಾ, ಎಷ್ಟು ನೀವ್ ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಆಗ್ತೀಯಾ, ಯಾರು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೀನು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಎಷ್ಟು ಅವರು ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಈ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಜನ್ಮ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದೀವಿ ನಿಜ, ಆದ್ರೆ ಅವರ ಹಣೆ ಬರ ಆ ದೇವರ ಕೈಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಏನ್ ಇಷ್ಟನೋ ಅದು ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೆ ಸಾಧಿಸಕ್ ಇಷ್ಟ ಪಡ್ತಾರೋ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಂಕರೇಜ್ ಕೊಟ್ರೆ ದೇವ್ರಿಗಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಸಂತೋಷ ಪಡೋರು ಯಾರು ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಏನಂತ, ಲೆಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಆರ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಬಿ ಫಾರ್ ಗ್ಲಾಡ್ನೆಸ್. ಗ್ಲಾಡ್ನೆಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿನೆಸ್. ಸೊ ನೀನ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗ್ತೀಯೋ, ಎಷ್ಟು ನಿನಗೆ ನಿನ್ನ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬೆಂಡ್ ಆಗ್ತೀಯೋ, ಅವಾಗ ದ ಆರ್ಚರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಬಿ ಫಾರ್ ಗ್ಲಾಡ್ನೆಸ್. ಫಾರ್ ಈವನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಈ ಲವ್ಸ್. ನೋಡಿ, ಯಾಕೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಗೋ ಇನ್ ಅನದರ್ ವೇ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. For even as he loves the arrows, how God loves the arrows that flies. See now, so nice, that flies. Who is going to fly? Arrows here. That means generation. The next generation has to fly. They have to lead the life. That is the world. That is the universe. So he loves also the bow that is stable. So not only he loves the arrows that flies. Okay? Understand? Arrows, they are meant to develop in their life, progress in their life. That is fly here. So he loves also the bow that is stable. So he knows that bows are always must be stable because the arrow should fly. So God not only loves the arrows, he also loves the stable. That is stable. Who is stable here? The bows which are stable. The same love what he gives to the children, God also loves the same, in the same pitch, same phase for the parents, because parents also are the sons and daughters of the God. So like this, Gibran gives the practical view of thing for the parents to change their the possessiveness and ask the parents to have an introspection what they are demanding from their children. Maybe it appears very practical. Really, it is practical, students. Somewhere in our Indian text, it may not appear. Somewhere we won't go against our parents' wish. I know this, but still, we parents should change their attitude, their thinking, because children have their own thoughts, own aims, own talents, where they want to achieve in these fields. So we parents should encourage these things. So like this, Al-Mustafa goes on advising Al-Mitra, where she asks for Al-Mustafa to talk about the children, how to be brought up children. Like this he says. Let me come with the reading, student. Once again, read it, understand it, and try to recollect wherever you got a mistake. You come to the WhatsApp and message me. I'll answer it. And a woman who held a babe against her bosom said, "Speak to us of children." And he said, "Your children are not your children. They are the sons and daughters of life's longing for itself. They come through you, but not from you. And though they are with you, yet they belong not to you." That means parents are just a vehicles or the stewardship. They have to have the stewardship. You can understand. They should help them. It doesn't mean they have to impose their thoughts. You may give them your love, but not your thoughts. For they have their own thoughts. You may house their bodies, but not their souls. For souls dwell in the house of tomorrow. House of tomorrow means future. House their bodies means you can protect them physically, not psychologically. Which you cannot visit. You can't visit their future, not even in your dreams. You may struggle to be like them, but seek not to make them like you. For life goes not backward, nor tarries with yesterday. You are the bows from which your children are leaving arrows are sent forth. The archer sees the mark upon the path of the infinite, and he bends you with his might, that his arrows may go swift and far. Let your bending in the archer's hand be for gladness, for as he loves the arrow that flies, so he loves also the bow that is stable. So like this, I like to end, students. Go with the comprehension in the next video. Let me come with the analysis of the poem, and extra points I'm going to add, and in the next I'm going to give assignment in the next week. Thank you, students. Hope you understood. Anywhere you have a doubt, you can contact me personally. Thank you.